Coding Challenge Review. Intermediate.
30th of January.
Last challenge of the month, guys. Question number one. Get mean value. Right? We've solved the problem lots of times already, I believe. Let's quickly do it again. How many arguments do we receive?
One,
correct. It's a list of numbers, right? Numbers. So then, can we do return math.mean numbers? Not really. Not really. Correct. You are all right. So, guys, please mute yourself unless you want to participate. Thank you. So, So numbers is an array. Unfortunately, math.mean only accepts a comma-separated list of arguments, which we can easily tweak, right? By simply, is that gather or spread? Spread, that's correct. We spread from an array to a comma-separated list of values, right? Any question, any problem? All good, right? Brilliant. What do you do here? You thought I forgot that, huh? Math.mean, numbers, you see, values. To me, the semantics look much better. So that looks much more professional than at the beginning of the bootcamp. Ashley, the winner. The winner, that's unacceptable for the winner of the number. It's not a number, right, Ashley? It's numbers, plural. Look at Richard, for example, numbers. Numbers everywhere, right? Cool, question number two, transform. Ooh, again, we've done that like 20 times already. Transform, how many arguments do we receive?
One.
Tell me argument name.
Function.
FN or func, something like that, right? Right? Don't call it Margaret Thatcher, right? That doesn't make sense. FN. So then what? So we need to invoke the function passing a number, right? N. So whatever the number is, it has to return 12. So in the first example, we need to multiply the number by 3, right? So 3 times the number gives 12. What's the value of N? 4. It can only be 4, right? FN4. That's it, right? Correct. Easy. Rafa. Wrong. Number. It's not a good argument name. It's not a number, it's a function. This is extremely confusing. If I read that line, I would say, okay, Rafa is expecting to transform a number into another number, but that's not correct. It's transforming a function, right? Poppy, all good. Jaff. Jaff. So, Jaff, are you there? No? Yeah. So, it's interesting, right? Because ignoring the how weird the function name is, and ignoring the thing that he added some comments. I believe you got some penalties, right? If you add comments on the code. Yeah, so I guess you get penalties on the elegance. Because and if you don't get any penalty, you should get the penalty on the elegance. Because you shouldn't add comments into the code. I know this is a bit controversial. I know some developers like comments. Actually, the first time I arrived to this country, I was still keen to add comments, but after speaking with lots of developers, I changed my mind. I think the comments should be necessary. If you need to add a comment to explain your code, it's because your code is not readable. The code should be self-readable. You shouldn't need to add any comment, right, for that. Yeah. No, generally. No. And actually, some elegance engines, they don't allow you to push anything if you have comments. Yeah. Because the code should be readable by definition. And if it's not readable, what you need to do is to change the code to make it more readable, split it, rename the variables, you know. also writing tests. We'll talk about tests as well, right? But in that particular case, the comments don't provide any value. On top of that, I noticed that Jaf, he spent like 15 minutes trying to solve the problem because he forgot to add a K here. So obviously, funky without K didn't work, right? Or with a C, something like that, right? So it was a misspelling here, right, Jaf? Cool. Thank you, Jaf. Cheers. And please mute yourself because it's a bit, yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Bala, function, Richard, function, Aisel, fun. Cool. Question number 3. Short actors. That's a good one. Let's do that again, even though we already reviewed this one. So we have a list of actors. Let me change the contrast of the screen. Yeah, I'm not sure which one is worse, to be honest. So, okay, let's leave it there. We have a list of actors, and we want to sort them. We want to display the youngest one first, I believe, right? So, argument name. Actors, easy, right? Because we want to sort actors, we can use the sort method on arrays, right? So we can do actors dot sort. So then how many arguments the callback function of sort receives? Two. Actor one and actor two, or actor A and actor B. Yeah, you can, no, yes, A, B, whatever you want. Two actors, right? I mean, to me, yeah, of course you can use A and B, but I don't like that because A, what's A? You're forcing me to go deeper into the function to understand what A means. If I put actor A, right, I can easily understand what type of data I'm dealing with, right? So then we want to sort the youngest one first. Do we need to sort the array on ascendant or descending order? Descending order, correct, correct. So then, what goes first? B, nice one. B dot born, I believe, right? Correct. Actor B dot born minus actor A dot born. Anything else? Correct, we need to map it. That's correct, because we don't want to return the same array in a different order. We just want the name of the actors. So which method in JavaScript transforms an array into another array of the same size? Map, correct. Well done, guys. Map, argument name? Actor, correct. Actor.name, correct. That's pretty much it, right? We can probably even inline, look, you see? Even better. Look at how elegant this is. Actors, short them, and then get the name. Correct, simple and easy to read, yeah? Look at how important the indentation is. If I do something like that, first sort and then map. They're equally important, one after the other, sequential order, right? Will this work? Yes, all good. So what you did here, guys? Rafa, same thing, right? Good. Poppy. Oh, that's quite long. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. So Poppy. That's interesting. What's the point, Poppy? Of.
I just wanted to make sure that was a pawn. So I just turned it into an object.
But you're doing nothing, right? So you have an array and you return another array which is literally the same array. So that's a bit unnecessary, right? You do nothing because your array of factors have these two properties. So then you return another array with the same number of elements and each element has the same number of properties. So that's a bit unnecessary. And then here, you sort them, fine, and then you map them, right? Because of a reason, for Poppy, now they are stars, right? So she's changing the naming conventions. I'm not convinced about that. Because
Ricardo?
Yeah.
Quick question there. So when we do a sort, will that mutate the array?
Yes, it will mutate the array. That's correct. That's
so in Poppy's case, she's trying to avoid that, if, as I see it.
Okay. Was that your intention, Poppy, to create a pure function instead of an impure function?
Say yes.
Right, so I think Bali is right, right? Nothing is strictly wrong. He's right. He gave a good argument to do that, not against that, right? Yep. So if you don't want to mutate your inner array, then it's fine to do this thing, right? What is completely unacceptable is having two spaces here. I mean, you I'm pretty sure you get a penalty on the elegance, right? No? No? Okay. And then, so I suggest to avoid this kind of naming conventions, right? We should try to be very opinionated. So here we are asking too much, right? We know the actors are stars. Maybe not. Maybe they are just average actors. They are not the stars, right? So the code should be a bit,
Yeah.
Cool. Thank you, Poppy. Jeff. So Jeff is sorting the array. Fair enough. And then he has another array with the names, which is fine, you see. But I find this code a bit complicated because you can do the same thing using map. You see what he's doing? So he has another array of actor names, and then he's pushing the name of each actor.
Yeah, I definitely wanted to go pure.
Yep. But that's not pure. That's not pure because here you already modify the array. You see, actor object array dot sort. This is mutating the original array, so that's not pure at all. Poppy's option. That's actually pure. That is pure because she is not modifying the original array, but you are modifying the original array.
I'm reordering it, but you can't rely on the order. I thought.
You can. Why you can't? I'm not following you yet.
Okay.
Right. So I mean, again, don't get me wrong. That's fine. I don't have any concern. My only concern is you had to type a lot. Right. You see how simple this is using sort and map.
Agreed.
Cool. Thank you, Jeff. Bala, sort and map, all the same. My only concern for Bala is the separation. Right. So look, actors.sort. I will personally move sort to a new line. I find it helps to read the code. Because otherwise, okay, see that map, but map of what? Oh, there is a sort on the right-hand side. So I find, and that could be a personal thing, but for example, what Rafa did, yes, I find this code a bit easier to read. First sort and then map. So the output of sort is the input of the next action, the mapping one. Then Ashley, he's using the same thing, sort and then map, right? Again, I would recommend to move the dot. Every time you have a dot, put it on a new line, like Natasha did, you see? So even Natasha, she's adding explicit return, but from an indentation point of view, that looks very good to me. That looks perfect. She's doing a sort, and then on the same logical line, she's doing the map. Cool. Acel, the same problem, right? So before the sort, before the dot, move it to a new line. I mean, even though we're discussing all these details, as you can see, these are actually details, right? At the beginning, we had to complain about so many wrong things. At the moment, just fine-tuning small things, right? Richard, so he created a new variable, still mutating the original array, but creating a new variable, and then using a for each. So very similar to what Jeff did, right? Very similar. Create a new array, and then pushing each actor name to the array. And I think that's it. So any question about this exercise? No? Cool. Question number 4, change sequence. How many times we've done that already, guys? Change sequence. So how many arguments the function receives? One. What type of argument we have here? It's a number. That's correct. So then I'm going to use an arrow function straight away. So that function
number one.
Correct. So the function, okay, let's call it number one. Correct. The function essentially returns another function, right? And the other function returns another function. Another number, correct. So we got three, how many nested functions? Two, right? So the first function returns another function and the other one returns another one. So then we can simply multiply number one by number two by number three, right? And that should be pretty much it. We can get rid, of course, of the parentheses, right? And that should hopefully work. What do you think? Will this work, yes or no? Yes? Let's have a look.
Yeah.
Yes, it does work. Right? That's, in my opinion, the simplest way to create a nested list of arrow functions. So what do you do here? Change sequence. Rafa, same thing. Poppy, you see, that's the same thing. See, comparing Poppy and Rafa, and I'm not very opinionated. I cannot tell you which one do I prefer. So Rafa's one is more precise because it's one line. But on the other way around, I find Poppy's solution a bit easier to read because I can see the sequence, the way the functions are nested. And on top of that, with Poppy's approach, I can add several breakpoints. So I can debug, I can evaluate the value of number one, number two, and number three, right? So in that particular case, I find Poppy's solution a bit more elegant, but again, not very opinionated. Same thing for Jaff and Ashley, Bala, arrow functions, Richard, arrow functions. I mean, you know, you can see the two approaches, right? And I, as I said, both are equally valid. There is no perfect solution. It depends what do we want to sacrifice. Last question, worst movie ever. So we have an array of movies. So we want to sort them. You want to sort them? Not really, right? What do we need to get worst recent movie? Oh, I think, yeah, that question is a bit confusing. Yeah, we don't want to get the worst recent movie. We just want to get the average of each movie, right? Actually, we're talking about horrible movies. Not sure if you've seen any, if you've watched any of them. But the thing is, we just want to get the average, right? So how do we get a new array very similar to the original array with different data? Map, correct. So we got movies, return, movies, dot, map. And then, for each movie, what do we want to return? An object, right? Name, movie.name. And then score. You see, we want to transform the array of scores into a single score, which is the average. As you already know, every time I want to deal with these things, I create a new function. That will be particularly convenient on the expert, because on the expert, as some of you, I'll show you something that Itamar did this morning. I'm not going to explain what he did, but I'll show you, just to prove how complex expert could be. That's why it's so convenient to create utility functions, like get average. So I don't care what kind of data I'm dealing with. I receive a list of numbers. How do we get the average, guys, out of a list of numbers? Reduce, correct. Reduce what? First argument. Average, second one. What? Value. Why, if we are dealing with numbers, now we call it value, right? Be consistent. I don't care. If you use values here as well, right? Readability. Number. Return what? Average plus number divided by numbers. Anything else? Default value. Ah, you learned the lesson, huh? 0.0, correct. Correct. So now we can simply do score get average. What? Movie. Numbers. Yeah. Why not numbers? Scores. Plural. Yeah. Will this work?
No.
Why not? We need to change the name of the function. Nice. That's a tricky one. It's very easy to get a penalty on the elegance. No, on the accuracy, actually. So you see, we're invoking a function called get worst recent movie. But if we pay attention, in reality, the function here has a different name. That's cheeky. It's a way to prove that you, me, we tend to ignore this kind of details, right? So as soon as we update the function name, will this work?
No.
Why not, Natasha?
Because movies don't map. You need to add, instead of movie, you have to put movies, plural, movies.
Where?
Function.
In it says movies.
Movies.map.
Yeah?
Movies.
What? I'm not following you.
Here.
So Natasha is suggesting that the argument name should be in plural. Is that correct? No, of course not, Natasha. So this refers to each single, each individual movie on the list.
Okay.
Every time you do map, same as find, same as filter, you remember? Fruits.find, fruit, right? Characters.filter, character. Movies.map, movie, right? Cool. Do we need to round anything, guys? Round? No? I don't know, probably not. Okay, no, cool, fair enough, cool. So let's try that. Nice, all good, guys. So what do you do here? So Rafa, so he's pretty much the same thing. Instead of creating a utility function, he put everything in one line, in one single function. Poppy, you see, I like that. So Poppy, she just create a new function. I will personally rename count with average, right? Because that's what you're returning. If the function is get average, I will put average here. Jaff, again, creating a function. I personally disagree with Jaff by calling that total. Because to me, total makes sense when you are adding, when you're doing a sum, right? 2 + 3 + 4, what's the total, right? Here we're not calculating the total, we're calculating the average. Also, not sure, Jaff, why you call the argument name scores A. Do you have any scores B?
I think I was trying to signify that it was an array.
I see what you mean. But why then movie O array?
Objects array.
Not convinced about, well, I see your point. The thing is, I don't think there is any standard about that, right? But anyway, that's an interesting proposal, of course. And Bala. So, guys, please mute yourself. Thank you. He gets the average, and then he... let me read that. Ah, no, sorry. So, he creates a get average function, which is an arrow function, and then he invokes the function. You see what Bala did? So that's, he's the same thing, it's the same structure, but instead of creating a classic function, he's creating a narrow function, right? We'll learn how to do that. And then Richard, same thing, Aisel, pretty much the same thing, and same thing for Natasha. So, I think that's pretty much it, guys. Any question, any problem? Anyone? Bala, Richard, Jeff?
Nothing else for me.
No, I'm good.
Cool. You remember, guys, 3 weeks ago, it took 60 minutes to complete 4 questions. Now it took 31 to complete 5 questions. That's the way you see you progress, right? We don't need to repeat the same principles again and again. It's something that, you know, it just works, right? Cool. That was it for today. Thank you, guys. See you soon.